Oh, Tu sai che ci ho preso. Thank you. Thank you. Oh! notte, giorno, il giorno, boia, sempre dietro a te.
Joan Sutherland has sung A Forza Lui and Sempre Libra from Verdi's La Traviata to the Los Angeles Philharmonic Orchestra conducted by Richard Bonney. Here again, Joan Sutherland on stage. Here comes Mark on stage with a beautiful bouquet of American Beauty roses. Wonderful combination with that beautiful gown. And she hands one of the roses to concertmaster David Pizzina.
Thank you. Callus at that time?
Callus, most certainly. Of course, how silly of me.
Tell me about her.
Callus and Stignani.
What was the most impression
Zinka
of Callus?
Milanoff. It was a shock. I mean, a wonderful shock. You just got shivers up and down the spine. It was a bigger sound in those earlier performances than it was once she lost weight. I think she tried very hard to recreate the sort of fatness of the sound that she had when she was as fat as she was. But once she lost the weight, she couldn't seem to sustain the great sound that she had made, and the body seemed to be too frail to support the sound she was making. But it was exciting, it was thrilling. I don't think that anyone that heard Callus after 1955 really heard the Callus voice at all.
Backstage, was she...
Oh, she was wonderful. She was marvellous. She was easygoing and a worker. Oh, my goodness me. She'd rehearse and rehearse. Always full voice, never pushing the sound, but she would work until she got what was wanted. And, of course, had very poor eyesight. She used to pace out how many steps she could go when there were steps and different levels on the stage, as there were in Norma. She knew how many paces she could take before she had to take a step, because she was blind as a bat. She had terrible eyesight and, of course, couldn't wear contact lenses at that stage. She did later.
Did you feel at that time that you were in at the end of an era at Covent Garden, or that you were starting something altogether new, that somehow there was a changeover of generations?
No, I didn't feel that then at all. of course, the change came about. As I said, when I first went there, all the operas were done in English. And we had sort of special gala performances, which were in Italian, which, of course, the norma was. The company, by and large, learned everything and performed everything in English. And the changeover only began to come towards, after I'd been there 6 years or so. And then some of the performances were actually prepared in Italian. For instance, the Otello was in Italian. But I really never got the chance to sing anything first cast until I was given the Lucia.